Have you heard about the new version of the Corona Render? Today, let's talk about Corona 7. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, I will take my first look at the newest Corona update and I will talk about the main changes. Before we start though, make sure to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you won't miss any future tutorials. Okay, it looks like they made a lot of changes to materials, so let's start with this. The biggest change we can see is the new physical material. So let's see how it looks. I will use the scene from our ArcBiz Artist training to test the new options. If you want to check it out, I put the link in the corner. Anyway, let's see the new material. Okay, it looks quite different from the Corona material we know from previous versions. By the way, we can still find it with the name Corona Legacy Material. There are more options in the Basics option panel. Media options look similar, but the naming is different. Here we have some changes like IR mode, for instance. The maps panel look the same, except for the fact we have different naming for them. The options that are totally new are ClearCoat layer and Sheen layer. It's like in Vray, and it's good to have it in Corona as well. ClearCoat layer, as the name says, is supposed to simulate a sort of coat applied to the materials, for example, varnished wood or carpet. Sheen layer, on the other hand, is helpful when you want to create fabric materials with the sheen effect, like velvet or silk, that was always a tricky material to create. Now, it will be easier to achieve realism with this option. The basic parameters are a bit different as well. We can determine if the material is metallic or not, plus if the object has a thin shell or not. But the true beauty of this material are presets that can speed up a workflow a lot. There are 35 presets of common materials. Let's test them. Let's say aluminum brushed. Cool, we can of course adjust materials if needed or add textures, but the base is nice. Let's see another one. All materials are without textures, but we can make them even more realistic by adding some. We can use our own or textures from the Corona material library. Let's see some brass. Nice. Glass frosted. By the way, they also improved the glass. It gives more realistic reflections and refractions. Let me show you how it looks on the table leg. Let me show you the material from different perspectives. I would need to adjust it here a bit. Let's try to decrease the roughness value. Okay, better. Let me show you a couple more, so you have a great overview on what to expect. We can check gold as well. We need to click OK here. Gold brushed looks really nice. Let's see it from another view. Maybe plexiglass. That's interesting. I like this green edges effect. Let's see how it looks from the top. It It looks cool from here as well. Let me show you the velvet material, but let's add it to the armchairs. I copied the material and set it to velvet preset. Let me pick the original material from the armchair. I will switch the materials. Here we go. Let's move it closer to see it better. It's nice. For sure, it will be better if we add some textures, but even without it, looks nice. We can change parameters. And you can see that the material uses Sheen layer. We can control it by amount and roughness. Let me quickly show you what is changing. You can see that Sheen effect is changing. I show you this from another perspective. Here it looks much better. Would you like me to do a more detailed video about new Corona physical material? Let me know in the comments. When we talk about materials, with the Corona 7 we'll get the updated material library. Let me quickly show you a couple of new materials. I create a box. And let's apply this material for instance. I need to add a UVW map modifier. Maybe 0.3 by 0.3 by 0.3. We can see tiling, but let's see how it will look rendered. Start interactive rendering. Let me turn down the environmental light a bit. That's really good. Maybe displacement is too big in this case, but we can always adjust it in the material settings. Let me show you another one. And one more. The materials are really nice. They need some adjustment depending on the scene, but in general we can use them pretty often for our work. Let me show you some woods. Let's see. Nice. By the way, they improved the displacement in Corona 7. It's more detailed. We also have a new sky model. Let's take a quick look. I will test it on the exterior scene from our Arvis Artist training I mentioned before. This scene was made in the older version of the Corona, so you can notice that it's automatically set to the old model. However, we can choose the new one from the list. Choose PGR Clear Sky. And let's start interactive rendering. Okay, nice. I don't have to really change anything. However, you can see that we have some new options here. This improved model section is new. We can set the altitude and volumetric effect in the sky. Let me show you how the volumetric effect works. You need to check it. You can notice it a bit here, but let's increase the value. Cool! This effect is pretty nice and also so easy to do. Besides, we also have a sun selection option and we can also change to opacity here as well. Besides this, they also improve the rendering time thanks to calculating passes in the blocks. And the process of denoising is also faster. Additionally, opening the scene is quicker thanks to the fact that textures and proxies are loaded in the background. Plus, there is no problem with artifacts in the huge scenes. To sum up, in general, I think that this is a good update, especially with this new Corona physical material and presets. It can give you much better results and speed up your workflow at the same time. If you would like to master your Corona skills, I'd like to invite you to check out our visualization course, where we teach you step by step how to create beautiful images. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye bye!